One of the best ways to add color and interest to your presentations is to add shapes. There are a lot of different shapes to choose from, and they can be fully customized with colors, effects, and shape styles. To get started, go to the Insert tab, and then click Shapes. And then just select the one that you want. I want the no symbol because it's going to go on top of this paper towel clip art. Click on the shape, and then click and drag on the slide, and the shape will appear. And if it's not in exactly the right place, you can just click and drag to move it. This shape is a little too big right now, so I'm going to use the resizing handles to make it a little bit smaller. And these are found on the sides and the corners of the shape. Every shape will also have a green handle that you can drag to rotate it. And if it has a yellow handle, then you can use that to make other adjustments to the shape. But not every shape has that. This shape still isn't very exciting, so let's start customizing it. With the shape selected, click on the Format tab. The quickest way to customize a shape is by choosing a shape style. And you can click on the drop-down arrow to view all of them. These add colors and effects at the same time. And I think I'll go with this reddish style. This shape is done now, and since we used a shape style, it took almost no time at all to make it look nice. You can also customize text boxes in the same way, because a text box is just a type of shape. But for this one, I have a very specific look in mind, so I'm going to customize the colors and effects individually. And these options are found right next to the shape styles. For the shape fill, I'd like this light beige color. And for the outline, I want something that will match the no symbol on the right. Under shape effects, there are several different types, but I want to focus on the two different types of 3D effects, bevel and 3D rotation. Bevel will add a kind of curved or grooved edge to the shape. And 3D rotation makes it seem like you're looking at the object from a different angle. And I like to combine these two different effects to get a kind of realistic look. So for shapes and text boxes, it's totally up to you whether you want to use shape styles to quickly format the appearance, or if you want to really get into the details by adding your own colors and effects.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.